Move the same way that the wind blows. What I need to know how to swim for. Feels better when you drown. It could all be so simple. What I need to know how to swim for. Feels better when you drown. In this life, I leave behind a wife, two kids and some rice. Spend my life wondering what's my price. Busy picking ice. Move the same way that the wind blows. What I need to learn how to live for. Feels better when you drown. I ain't too mad not to admit that I'm not brave. I ain't too mad not to admit that I don't feel brave. Well, I'm a shipwreck in a quiet storm. What about runaways? You'll never find me if I remain. So I'll stay underground and remain. It's acid in my shower. Freedom tastes so sour. Standing on this tower, I should jump right now. But jokes up on me now, I'm too much of a coward. Freedom tastes so sour. Freedom tastes so sour.
So many miles and memories from that block. Feels like I jumped on silver bird and never came back. I never get to see you, but you always hold me down. You never fought me when I leave you. One thing we're coming back around. It's like I never get a minute. Feels like I'm never not on tour. Sometimes I start to miss you. What am I doing all this for? I wanted to be better, a better brother. To be there for my sister, no father figure. Come on for the summer, be with my mother. I'm not an only son, but what is my brother? Protect her from the bad men, come from the gutter. Said she'd be okay and I had to trust her. Sometimes you gotta leave and don't even want her. Sometimes you gotta leave and don't even want.
Never get much time at home. Usually, yes, always on standby. But you by my side anyway. Yeah, getting real comfortable just sitting in the same place. It's kinda weird that I can put away my suitcase. I'm trying to take advantage of all of the same space that I shared with you. It's like our time is on a meter. Until I go back out on tour, it's like I never get to see you. What am I doing all this for? I wanted to be better, a better brother.
To be there for my sister,
be there
for the figure.
My sister,
come on for the summer,
yeah, yeah.
Be with my mother. I'm not an only son, but
where is
my brother? Protected from the bad man,
got
her. She said she'd be okay and I had to trust her.
Sometimes you gotta leave
and don't even want her.
Sometimes you gotta leave when you don't even want her. Fly with me, fly with me. Cause you know we don't got long. Fly with me, fly with me. Sometimes you gotta. Sometimes I get to stay behind and enjoy life. There's a point of 9 to 5 to 5 waiting for the wait time. It's a way of mine. Sometimes I leave and don't even wanna. I wanted to be better, a better sister.
Better.
Be there for my brother, you know I love you.
You know I love
you. Be there for
you.
My mom, she know all my songs, yeah. I don't wanna leave, I just really want
you. You know I'll be on
there for my daddy. But this I do friendship up with my plans, yeah. Sometimes you gotta leave, you don't even wanna. Sometimes you gotta leave.
Hey. Ladies and gentlemen. Ladies and gentlemen. Oh, we're back. Oh, we're back, all right. Welcome to Nice Live, number 40, Roommate Live. Broadcasting inspiration, screaming into the void. No rules, all heart. I'm Ricky Reed, and I am feeling okay. Feeling okay. Holy moly. I got a drink. I need unlimited wine tonight. I need the bottomless wine. Ladies and gentlemen. Wow. Welcome to the Room record release party. An album that all of you, most of you, have been here for since the very beginning. You saw the moments that created it, that started it. You've seen the whole journey. I'd like to say hello to everyone in the chat, all the OGs. I see you all there. We're seeing some donations coming in tonight. You know, we're raising money for the Good Life Garden, for Scope in LA, and Native Renewables in the Navajo Nation. So please, if you are feeling so inclined or you are able to, donate what you can, but also check out those organizations. We're going to be sharing some info on them later. It's going to be a big night. We've got some shit for you guys. Everybody in the chat. Oh, Justin Kastner already coming in. It's got 8.9 energy. Let me know how you're feeling on a scale of 1 to 10. Decimal point included. I want to know. I got a little kick and snare action ready for you. Whatever you need. Ooh, boy. I see we got some Alessia Cara fans in the house. Hello, hello, hello. Kihan, hi. Boy, Sam Berger, what's up? Anonymous, $50 donation. Godfather, 6.9. Loving it. JM Roos, 9.9. Brad, 10.01. Love to see it, dude. Josh, a 10. We got 10s tonight. Should I do the real magic? Never been, ever seen. Tens in the chat, that's everything. Everybody's feeling pretty nice tonight. DJ Philly, what's up, dude? One of our remix contest folks. Evan Mahalski, Alexander Freed, and the whole crew. Win Hartford, thank you for the donation. Larry Wade, 9.9. Wrench Gang in the house. We got some folks. We got some folks. Mama Wade. Tell Mama Wade I said what's up. Man, I'm like pulsing with energy right now. I'm feeling good. I'm feeling excited. I want to bring in somebody who is usually capable of taking me down a notch when I need it. Putting a big old smile on my face. I know you guys are going to be happy to see her. Let's bring out the one and only Jazz is in the building.
Hey, everybody. It's here. What's up, chat?
What's up? Jazz, I was hoping you would have said, hey, everybody, I'm here.
Yeah, I'm here. It me. Hey, everyone.
Man.
Yo, I can't believe we're 40 episodes in.
40, dude. This is 40.
This is 40.
This is
Wow.
40. Oh my gosh. How you doing tonight?
I'm doing good. My sister made me a really smoked out margarita. So we're celebrating.
Yes. Cheers.
And yeah, I'm feeling good that this album is 15 minutes away from being out and in the hands of everybody.
That's
A
what you
lot of
want
good
to see.
songs. I feel like playing the demos or even just hearing them after. We were making them literally live with everyone.
Right. These folks have been a part of
Yeah,
it,
they
man,
just
from the jump.
totally. And I think that, Michael's, we just saw his live performance. All of these songs, they hit like such. I felt like what is expressed in a lot of these songs at different points so far during quarantine. So I feel like the project, I don't know, I think everybody's gonna really sit with it and like have, yeah, it's just gonna be one of those albums that you really resonate with.
Damn. Thanks, Jazz.
Yeah, of course.
Out here, out of marketing department out here, repping.
I just feel like, we always start off the show with how we're feeling, and there's a lot of different feelings on this album. And I'm excited that it gets to be in everybody's hands and people get to
Yes.
feel it too.
I'm with you, man. I'm with you. It's been a tumultuous week, and we'll talk to Michael about it, of course, in a minute, about his performance just now. But this shit is like, it's hard. I'm trying to think of the right words. It is really, really important to remember, even when you're in a minute of pause and you're feeling like everything's really good, and maybe you got a little caffeine going and you're getting excited and ambitious. It's like, I'm trying right now to also, when I'm ramping up, to also recognize, like, hey man, be calm, be cool, because next week might be one of those weeks. And right now, this is a bright spot in the middle of a really rough week. You know what I'm saying?
Totally.
So trying to, mental health wise at least, let the lows be a little less low. And for me, that also means like keeping an eye on myself when I'm letting myself run away with escapism joy, because I
Totally.
do that shit.
I definitely do that too. So yeah, I feel like, I don't know, I think just keep with even that in mind, like that the album feels like that too to me. Like there'll be like really kind of just a song that leans into, I don't know, just that feeling of like, I mean, if you're talking about it in this first song,
Right.
like feeling like drowning or feeling like overwhelmed, which I think a lot of people relate to. And then they you also have songs like Real Magic, which is like real too
Right.
and honest, but there is like a it feels hopeful and it feels like uplifting at the same time. So yeah, I don't know.
Hey man.
I'm
Hope.
excited to be here with everyone and celebrating and
Yes. Cheers to your smoky margarita. I'm gonna cheers you. I'm starting with wine. Clink. Did you get you got the
I just cut to it.
tight. I love that. Yeah, I'm like trying to find the right balance of like bring my heart rate down, but also like be fucking on point because man, I'm my own technical director over here and the shit is.
I was gonna say you gotta pace yourself because we got a lot of performances coming up,
Yes.
and so you gotta be able to be pushing all the knobs and buttons and things.
Straight up, straight up. Okay, so I'm gonna leave you in here with us, and I'm gonna bring out our first guests from the album, who just showed us the amazing video that he filmed in a shipyard for the song Shipwreck, which is actually the first song in the record, which is out in 10 minutes. We're gonna bring him out right now. I think he's coming to us from home. This is Michael Sneed. What's up, dude?
What's up, Michael?
Hey, guys.
How are you?
How are you guys doing?
Good.
I'm doing good.
Good. How are you?
Man, that shirt is... It's winning. That's a winner's. That's a winner's shirt. That's not a loser shirt, Michael. That's what you wear to win. How you doing?
Thank you. Good.
Good. Good. The video you sent in, completely changed the course of the project for making the videos for tonight. When we saw your video, we were like, these can't just be like little YouTube jam sessions the way people think of them. Like somebody really stepped up. Where did you get the idea to shoot it? Where are you in the video? Like, tell us about it.
So when you guys sent the email about doing the video, me and Sam called our friend Cedric to see if he could, help us shoot something. We didn't think it was going to be that grandiose. But when we were on the call with him, he was like, hey, it'll be tight. Because he listened to the song. He was like, hey, it'll be tight if we went to this this spot in San Francisco and there's this giant abandoned ship. And he sent us a picture. We were like, great, that looks great. It's probably a bit overboard, but like, when are we going to get the chance to do something like this?
Right,
let's
right.
do it. The day came that we were supposed to shoot, and the fires started going off right. in the Bay Area, and it was one of the fires was right by that location.
Wow.
So we had to look for a new location 10 minutes before we had planned to shoot. And we found a spot in Alameda. It's a pier where a lot of the ships come in. And luckily there were like 3 or 4 ships there when we arrived and we shot there.
Wow.
Like,
I mean,
yeah.
It's so powerful. I have a lot of friends in the Bay. Jazz, do you have any people up in the Bay?
That are living there right now? No, but I have a lot of homies from the Bay down here. We got Danny, who actually has this brand, Kids of Immigrants, from the Bay. We're out. Monica, who styles John Robert, is from the
dope.
Bay.
Nice.
Nice. Yeah, we love the Bay.
We got some folks. Yeah. So, I mean, I've had 2 friends of mine evacuate from the sort of like Santa Cruz Peninsula area, and then also.
Oh no.
Yeah, it's rough down there. I mean, where me and my wife got married, we got married at a YMCA camp in the woods just north of Santa Cruz on the 9, and the fire was like right up to it like as a day or two ago, so I'm not sure if it got it. It's fucked up. It's really sad. So when I saw your video, I just recognized that haze. I mean, I know that you weren't right on top of it, but it's like you're out there in that smoky haze, and the fact that you decided to do the performance with the mask. I mean, did you actually think about, was the mask a conscious decision, or were you just like,
I'm yeah, just doing it
because I'm okay? Yeah, tell me about that.
Yeah, I was just like, it was more so like I would die. this would shorten my lifespan if I didn't do this without a mask.
It was a conscious health decision.
Yeah.
Yeah, dude, it's real, man. Dude. It's real. We had a small fire, probably the closest fire to where I live so far this season today. Really, really small. But I was walking my boys, and it was close enough to where I could see the plumes of smoke. And fires are a trigger for me, like bad, bad, bad. Like I get super anxious. But I've been working on it. I've been working on like this season, like bracing myself and getting ready for it. And it felt very fitting on the day of this show, seeing it and being like, it's small, they're taking care of it, and, you know, breathing through it and being like, all right. And I feel like I had a little personal mental health victory today with the fire in my neighborhood's backyard. So getting through this time is fucking hard, man.
Mm-hmm.
No, it's ridiculous. People on the East Coast don't understand fire season is like a real thing.
They don't. It's a whole thing. I know, but also, you know, like there's shit that we don't get that they have, you know. Like obviously me and
Totally.
Jazz were just talking before bringing you on this week, man, with Kenosha, obviously, that's so bad. And then what's happening in the southeast with hurricane season starting up, you know, Lake Charles, Louisiana, like
Hurricane Laura.
yes, man, it is. And that's also, I want to give a quick shout out to all the people. I'm seeing a lot of donations coming in the chat, which is tight. Thank you. We are raising money tonight for three organizations, a garden in Brooklyn, a renewable energy company in the Navajo Nation, and a mutual aid and climate action group in South LA called Scope. So people, if you feel so inclined, please make a donation. We're doing telethon vibes tonight. I gotta get like a cheesy like bell or something I can hit when we get one. But so Michael, what's next for you? What do you got going on? You got music coming? Like, what's the plan right now?
We're working on music.
I
We're
don't
working
know
on
why, but I
music.
just feel like I understood everything in that moment. Like, oh, I know that feeling.
I'm working on music, figuring out what we put out a project late last year, and due to COVID, we weren't able to roll things out. I mean, amongst a few other things like personal family issues, we weren't able to roll out that project the way we wanted to. So we're hoping this fall we'll be able to bridge the gap between the last project, Days We Lost, and the new music that we want to put out top of the new year, which will lead us into the next project. So that's exciting. It's been stressful, but it's really exciting.
Man, the last project was called Days We Lost, huh?
Which is ironic.
I mean, you know, Captain Obvious here, but like, what would you call, what would you call these days, you know, since March? Are these days lost, days found, somewhere in between? How would you describe this time for you?
I think for me personally, it is days of understanding, or maybe even days of growth. I think I've done a lot of growth, a lot of maturing. I know myself like better than I've ever known myself before. I don't think I've actually ever known myself until like these past like 3, 4 months.
Man.
Like me and myself, we best friends now.
Amazing. Yo, I'll tell you, there's nothing like being in a pressure cooker to figure everything out. It's crazy when all those decisions you make are so big, so crucial, and you have time to think and time starts stretching out the way it does during this, we get a good look at ourselves because the things we use to construct our identities, so much of that goes away. Even small shit. Every day I go to the coffee shop. Every day I do this, I do that. I go to shows about once every week and a half. These are the kind of shows I go to. Like all these different things go away, and then you're like, well, who, like, what is left now, you know?
Yeah. Like, how do you define yourself without others? You
That's
know,
big.
it's like you use people as your people are a reflection. You know, they're our mirrors. We get to see ourselves in people. We get to understand ourselves in people. So, like, when you're in a room all by yourself for
Man,
months,
that's a quote, honestly,
like
that
that
my wife actually
dog.
gives a lot. The mirror, she says, people are our mirrors, and we don't got them right now. But we're happy to have met you through this process, man, and to have get a little bit of
Likewise.
your wisdom, your musicality, your art. It's been amazing. So thank you again for the song, for being on the album, amazing music video. Yeah, man, we're just wishing you the best and hope that when we're done here, you jump in the chat. Hang with us.
Yep, I will. I'm going to, I don't drink, but I'm going to pop some Martinelli's for you.
There we go.
This is a big deal.
Thanksgiving energy. Totally. All right. Oh, man, well, thanks again so much. Michael, we'll talk to you soon, man. Thanks again.
All right, talk to you soon. Bye, Michael. All right, see you guys in the chat.
All right, peace. Okay, Jazz, we're going to switch over now. That was the first song on the album, and I'm going to spoil something here, but we're going to jump straight to the last song on the album. It's cool, I think, introducing the songs all this way in the stripped-down form. This is completely unproduced acoustic rendition of the final tune on the album. It's Dirty Projectors featuring Ioni No Stone.
All right. All right, here we go.
Where is the only word I know? Could it be better than before? Change without warning, just before morning, I listen.
What's up, dudes?
Hey, how's it going?
Hi. Welcome. Dave, you might be muted, which I appreciate. I appreciate your good housekeeping.
Thank you. Yeah.
Oh, man. Dave, this is Ioni. Ioni, this is Dave.
Hi, yeah. Nice to meet you.
Amazing performance of the song. It sounds so good.
Thank you. The guitar was
beautiful. Man. Two incredible voices. And, you know, also I'll say, obviously in that version, it's just one of each of you, but you guys are both crazy vocal arrangers too. I hadn't thought of that until this exact second. Really take the arranging seriously. Yeah. And brought some of that to the project. So where are you guys coming to us from right now? Dave, where are you at?
I'm in Los Angeles.
Okay. Are you at home?
Yep.
Nice.
Yep. Yeah, Echo Park.
Beautiful. I know it well. I got a studio before all this where I made all my music is same neighborhood, same zone. Ioni, where are you at?
I'm also in LA.
Nice. Home tonight? Yeah.
I sure am.
That light behind you look like you're at like the Beats Music HQ. very slick vibe. So guys, this is the first time you guys are talking, but the process of making this tune was really dreamy for me. I don't know if we've talked about it very much, but the way this thing started was Dave just guitar and melody, he just sent that raw, I think, right, Dave? Like no production or anything, wow. Right?
Yeah. I mean, because you had sent me some ideas that I really liked, and I wrote some melodies on them. And And then I also just sent you a thing that was like, oh, I just like made up this melody. It doesn't really have any words or anything. And it's just the guitar. But I don't know if you're interested in checking it out. Here it is.
Right. Well, this is like, okay, so I haven't had enough wine yet to like start embarrassing myself and fanning out on all my heroes. But I think the thing is when I get something just made by you purely from your brain, I'm like, oh, there's the fucking, that's the band I love. Like, that's the shit. Like, you know, some of your albums were like so big for me just when I was getting started, even doing the pop production and before that and bands I had played in. So when I heard the guitar and melody, like I had the feeling of like Temecula Sunrise or something. Like this gives me that hopeful sunrise energy. And I was really, really drawn to it.
Thanks, man.
Yeah, of course. Ione, what did you think when you first heard it?
I was really struck by it. And like the lyrics that I could catch, I just thought like, given the time that we were going through, I was in Houston at the time. And I was living with my family, but I just felt like I really connected to the lyrics and the melody. And also just the arrangement was really different and really fresh. Like I just really appreciated it. I thought it was really cool.
That's awesome. Oh, and you were in Houston when Houston mm-hmm. was the hot spot for COVID, yeah. right? Oh yeah. Man. Was that spooky?
Honestly, I didn't leave my house. Like I just produced in my room every day. So it was kind of nice. It just felt like I was 16 again, just home in my parents' house. It was really sweet.
Man, that sounds great. honestly, sometimes there's been a few days. Oh man, what was it? Early June, I think. Like the beginning, like right at the beginning of what we're referring to as the social progress movement. You know, mm-hmm. right after George Floyd, everything starts taking off, and obviously. There's so much hope and power and optimism in the movement. But as we've discussed a lot on this show, that plus COVID, like mm-hmm. activism, all these things together are a massive amount of energy requirement, emotional energy. And you know, a lot, it's can be hard to be hopeful some days. And there were some times in June, mm-hmm. man, where I wanted to just that exactly, just like go home.
Yeah.
Just go home for a minute. But I think this song, tying back to that, to me, you know, Dave, when we were working on the lyric for this, we went back and forth a little bit, which was one of the more fun processes on the album, was like working the lyric out for this song with you. And I think this is, with it being the last song, it's the most hopeful. I think it's the most hopeful song on the album. Do you actually feel hopeful? How do you feel right now?
Wow. You gotta be. Just on a temperamental level, I feel like an optimist more of the time than I resolve to pessimism. Mm. So maybe it's easier for me to say just because I'm maybe wired that way. Right. But I feel like, yeah, in a moment like this, when the stakes are so high and the possibility for real structural change, I think it, you know, is there. I think that we have to be optimistic.
I agree. I mean, I think optimism and hope is the only path. You know, but it's not blind optimism or ignorant, you know. Whatever, it's optimism with a lot of ass kicking and a lot of holding people to task. You know, I had a conversation with a friend of mine, and then went and read a few articles on it. Not to get too political, but just a thought, just a quick thought. I was reading a thing about how FDR, of course, we think of him as like the big structural change, progressive, this and that. How mm-hmm. that wasn't actually his bag or who he sought out to be. He was kind of a middle of the road guy, but he had an open mind and he let the activist wing of the party kind of beat him up a little bit. And from that came the New Deal. So I'm just maybe if we stay on it, maybe we can make lemonade. Aoni, how are you feeling? How are you feeling through all this? It's been a big week.
I take it a day at a time. I feel like the job of artists is kind of to push things forward and to be forward leaning and innovative in the way that we think and imagine the world can be. I think sometimes I kind of switch between feeling like, am I just, you know, too hopeful for like the future that I envision for the world and the things that I think are simple. But I think that our job is to fully believe and fully create a world that is just liberating.
I love, you said liberating, is that right? That's amazing. Just like, because that's like a verb and I do not know anything about tenses or where to, you're in school, you know the stuff, but like just that it's an action word and it is implying that it is a continuous thing. Mm-hmm. It is liberating as opposed to the idea that like a lot of people are sort of stuck on, like you get past Trump and then it's like, great, we're there.
The problems are so far, 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 far. I think what this country was built on is a bit of a curse. And so if we're going to do anything to learn a new way to exist, it's so far beyond Trump. It's, you know, in our everything that we're doing. And I love the fundraising that, you know, you're doing with this project. I think it's really beautiful that you're using your platform to just highlight people that are working towards a better future.
Oh man, thank you for that. And I actually need to pause and shout out a few because we've been getting so many donations this whole conversation. I haven't said a word to these awesome people. Most of them are anonymous, $10, $50, $50, but we had a big one, a Gonzo Lubel. Gonzo, $400 donation. An anonymous 500, 100. This is amazing.
Wow.
Dude, like since we started talking, Kelly Klatt, $25. Cool. Thank you, Kelly. And the thing we say too is like, obviously this is a really hard time. So we, you know, if people are able to, if they're so inclined, it's appreciated. But also on any of my social media pages, you can just learn about these groups. You can follow them. We have a community garden in Brooklyn called Good Life Garden, a renewable energy company in the Navajo Nation called Native Renewables, and Scope in South LA, who are amazing. They're doing like COVID mutual aid, but they were sort of born out of the LA Rebellion 1992, I think that was. Mm-hmm. And they do climate work. They have like this amazing neighborhood. Network of people that like during COVID, they literally go door to door and check on elderly people who are at, you know, higher risk. They're amazing. So
Ricky, how did you find and select these specific groups?
Thank you for asking. This group called the Solutions Project I'm partnered up with, they put me on to, so they work with grassroots organizations all across the country that are focused on climate and climate action. That's how I found Scope, Native Renewables. But the Good Life Garden in Brooklyn is Duendita's community garden.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. So I was talking to her. So each group is tied to one of the singles on the album, one of the artists on the singles. And I was talking to Candace Duendita and I was like, do you have anything you're passionate about? And she was like, check out my garden. And it's amazing. They turned a space that was literally like a trash dump space into this garden. And they taught me a lot about creating space in an urban environment for people who don't have space, just the concept of that, and especially a green space, you know. It's amazing.
Cool. Love that.
Yeah, it's great. So guys, I'm so thankful to both of you for coming through, being on the album.
Congratulations.
Oh my god.
Good.
Huge making moment. The video. Like, you guys are the best. If you're down, come through, hang in the chat. People will probably have a bunch of questions for you. Get that post show fan run up in the chat. Digitally.
For sure. Yeah. Ricky, thank you so much for having this idea and inviting us to it. And
it's been an honor.
It's really honestly really it's been an honor for me to work with both of you guys. And this song is my mom's favorite. I just need you guys. That's between us. All right. Thanks so much, you guys. I'll talk to you soon.
Thank you.
Yeah. Bye. Cheers. Bye. Oh, man. There's just so many nice folks in the mix tonight. How's everyone in the chat doing? You guys feeling good? I'm feeling wired still. Deeply wired. Oh, man. Another anonymous donation for $1,000. Thank you, Jake Jenkins. $5 donation. Thank you. Thank you. It's going all the way down. Maybe that's what I got to do every time it's a donation. All right, we're going to watch our next performance coming up right now. This is from an amazing, amazing, amazing talent on the album. Let me just get that queued up. This is the one and only, you guys from the chat might remember her. Oh, anonymous $150 donation. This is the amazing Malaya, accompanied on keys by Mike Blankenship, singing In a New Place. This shit is crazy. Enjoy.
Got a lot of time on my plate. I can let the day go to waste, but that ain't the way. Started going down in a day, laid up in my misery. That ain't the way. So I let my mind run away, travel to a newer place. And it turned out okay. I made a lot of discoveries. Too smooth with it. I know what to do with it, do with it. Don't get confused with it. I ain't talking about those feelings. Talking cool with it. I don't bust down, I'm too different. I got new limits, new visions, new intentions, yeah. I should have turned right when I veered to the left side. I never been a prisoner of direction. My senses tingled in a mess, and I'm hearing through my face and smelling with my hands. I'm picky with my sticky icky. Damn, I wish I could just quitty. Why? I don't have an answer, but I'm doing better. I don't even have to try. I know what to do with it. Yeah. Don't get confused with it. Talking about those feelings, talking cool with it. I don't bust down, I'm too different. I got new limits, new visions, new intentions, yeah. See, I ain't got no time for your words or your games, oh. Look, 'cause I'm flying on a plane to a better place, oh. You better learn my name before it's too late, oh. I'm here for your pleasure. I'm out here doing better, even if I don't try. Even if I don't try, I don't try. I don't try. Yeah, too smooth with it. Hey, I know what to do to do it. Don't get confused with it. Yeah. I ain't talking about those feelings. I'm talking cool with it. Hey, I don't bust down, I'm too different. I got new limits, new visions, new intentions, yeah.
Hey, I am at the Good Life Garden, a testament to what happens when community comes together. This was a space that was used as a trash dump for years. Neighbors came together, cleaned it up, and now we grow food, we offer workshops, have live music and entertainment to show each other what we can do when we come together and grow.
Hi everyone, I'm Wahela Johns. I'm with Native Renewables. We have 15,000 families on the Navajo Reservation that don't have access to electricity. What we have designed is this program that will help build a workforce, a solar workforce that means jobs for our people, and bring energy security for these families that live in really beautiful remote locations in the Southwest. We've designed an off-grid solar unit that will power refrigeration, appliances, lighting, for our future generations to be able to have a community that is generating power by clean energy.
We're in South Central Los Angeles at SCOPE. SCOPE was born out of the Los Angeles Uprising, which was a direct result of racist policies that were meant to marginalize and suppress our community. SCOPE opens its doors to community members so that they can organize and mobilize to address the problems and conditions that impacted the most, like police brutality, conditions of poverty, and environmental racism. We are South LA, and we are here to stay.
What up? What up? Welcome back. Oh my goodness. This is the night. This is the damn night. We still have donations rolling in. How good is that Malaya video? Man, she's insane. And Mike Blankenship, a little background on that video. She is playing, or she sent the video first, and she didn't do it to a click. She wasn't singing along to the song. She just did it in free time. And I hit up Mike, who's an amazing Bay Area keyboardist that I met through Nate Mercero. And I hit up Mike and I was like, can you play to this? It's not in time. It's loose, you know, and he just completely stepped up and crushed it. Just an amazing, amazing, amazing performance from Malaya, Mike Blankenship. I also want to shout out the people in the chat and the donations we have coming in. We have some people dropping major donations right now. We're going to shout a few out. Let's have a look what we are doing here. I want to shout these fools out. We got Anonymous donated $200. Thank you so much. Another Anonymous donation for $150. Amazing. Guys, so like I said, you guys have probably heard me talk about this before, but anybody who's new here tonight, you should know that we're raising money for three organizations: Native Renewables in the Navajo Nation, SCOPE in South LA, and the Good Life Garden in Brooklyn, in Bushwick neighborhood. We're just so, so, so happy to have all these people in with us. Okay, so we're getting our next guest ready. I'm going to pour a little wine and see how everyone in the chat's doing. If you're in the chat, let me know how you're feeling. Let me know how you guys are doing, which performances you've liked so far. What do we got? We got some more donations coming. $50 from Anonymous. Thank you so much. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Let's see, what else do we have here? Wow. We're already up to 15K, is that right? Oh my God. Incredible. Dude, it is cooking right now in here. Thank you guys so much. Yeah, this is just fine. I was talking about. JM Roos says, more wine, no wine, as in whining. Whoa! Anonymous just dropped a $500 donation, and thank you so much. We are rocking. This is fantastic. Nice thing about having Pro Tools in front of me is I can fade out this music. I can edit in real time. Whatever you guys like. Okay. Fantastic. So I'm going to bring out our next guest, and we will then be joined by another special guest. But my next guest is somebody who I have been a fan of for a long, 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 long time. He's passionate about all the issues we've been speaking of tonight. I'm sure that you're familiar with his work. We're going to bring him out right now. The one and only, ladies and gentlemen, this is Mr. Don Cheadle. Don, how you doing?
Good. Glad to be here with you, man.
Hey, man. Dude, our organizations are rocking tonight, man. It's going great.
I know. It's amazing at a time like this when, you know, people are, you know, so many people are struggling and we're trying to figure out how to get back to work and it's, you know, people are cinching their belts that they're still, you know, finding within their hearts and their generosity to throw down for all these different groups. It's really a testament to their work, your guys, you know, outreach and congrats everybody who's doing that. We appreciate it so much.
We really do. We really do. I mean, I was talking to my pops today, this morning, at a long walk with my baby boys. I was talking to him, and I couldn't tell if this is something to feel good about or feel bad about, but we were talking, and he's like, you know, it's just a time where the government, they're just not pulling their weight, and we all got to bind together a little more. The concept of mutual aid, obviously, is sort of a buzzword right now, but it's real. And to see people stepping up, and whether it's, you know, the donations are amazing, but as I tell people too, if you can just get educated, talk about, you know, following the Solutions Project, following Scope or Native Renewables or any of these organizations, you're familiar with Gloria's organization, Scope, in South LA, is that right?
Yeah, I was just on with Gloria today, talking to the California Endowment, trying to get them to do some work with us in Solutions Project, and really, you know, they got some big dough this year, so we're trying to get them to move climate change a little, you know, further to the forefront of the issues that they have to deal with, along with, you know, criminal justice and social justice and health and all of the issues that we have to deal with. But it's the intersectionality of all of these issues, which is really important that we recognize that climate is an umbrella over all of that, and it affects all of those different things.
Oh my God! And quite literally.
Yeah, we have to get busy because, you know, we only got this place here, and the earth will shut us off like fleas. It'll be fine, but we're gonna have problems. So we really need to get our arms around this issue and try to do everything we can to help one another and to bring a lot of voices into the fold.
Right. Hey, I'm with you. For me, okay. So for me, I jumped in more heavy on the climate stuff when I had kids, and I live in Los Angeles. Pretty close to the Angeles Forest, right behind me. So for me, forest fires are my thing. That's my trigger. And the bad air quality, it got two of my kids croup. I had to bring two of my three to the ER last year. Awful, awful.
Wow.
Tell me, for you, what's the personal connection to climate action? What's the thing that is in your guts about this? You know, a laundry list, but what's it for you?
Well, I think you, I mean, I'm a father as well. And it hit me in the same way that this is, you know, our children are inheriting a planet and an environment that they had no hand in creating, yet they're still suffering the deleterious effects of what we have allowed to happen and or have contributed to. So we got to call these, you know, corporations to the carpet, and we have to really, we have to do this for them. You know, this is something that they unfortunately are going to bear the brunt of, irrespective of their responsibility toward creating it. So that was my touchstone, and I've been very fortunate, and likewise, I'm sure you have. You know, I've been around the world, and I've seen how this has affected all of the places that I've gone to, and it's always the people that are most marginalized, right? The most disenfranchised that are most egregiously affected by this. So those voices have to be the ones that we hear from in this space. And in places like Scope, and you know, the other organizations that we're dealing with understand that, realize that, and are the frontline innovators in this area that are really coming up with the ideas to change this for themselves, because, you know, they got to do it for themselves. Like your dad's talking about, we got to do this now for ourselves, whether the government does it or not. We got to do it. Right. We got to push them for better solutions and vote and show up and demonstrate.
Oh my God.
And agitate. All of it. It's all a part of it.
I was just talking about this a few minutes ago. I was saying, you know, that there's too many people. A lot of people are going to vote, and that's going to be great. But there's still too many folks, I think, that feel like, you know, once we get past Trump, once we get past 2020, it's like, no, that's the starting line to get some shit done.
Absolutely.
That's the beginning.
Absolutely.
Like, holding these folks to task so hard for the next 4 years, march more, you know, like we need to be beating down the door.
100%. I agree. This is not an end. This is hopefully an introduction of an era, and we cannot relax and we cannot get lax and believe that we've achieved something just because there's an administration change, because the problems are still going to be happening. You know, we still, you know, there's still something to really look into as far as how we're allowing aspects of capitalism to run unchecked that throw off all of this waste that isn't dealt with. So it's not win at all costs. You know, we have to really think about the costs of winning and now how we have to show up every day and support each other to really get to some real solutions. Absolutely.
Oh my God, completely. Let's talk about music for a second. So I was not aware, but we found out recently that you're a musician. That's right?
What? I don't use that word in deference to real musicians, but yeah. I spend a lot of time messing around, playing the bass and in the studio and making music just for myself. And
oh, I've actually jumped past
pretty, like, I had a lesson yesterday with Alfonso Johnson, and I have a lesson tomorrow night with Chris Bride, and, you know, Rob is a close friend. That's how I know Terrace and how we happened to meet. So it's something that is, you know, I've been deeply steeped in. It's where I started. I had two roads, and I had a musician road and I had an actor road, and I picked the acting road. But now I'm getting back to that.
Oh, dude. I mean, if it was two roads and it was a decision you had to make, you are a bass player. Let's get real. You're playing with some real guys too. Damn.
I mean, I'm listening to some real guys, and they're teaching me the basics. Like, I went all the way back. I said, look, I need to go back to junior high school. You have to teach me theory. You have to teach, you know, I need major, minor, dominant. I need all of the chord. We have to, like, go through this like I'm a baby. So it's great. And Alfonso was like, well, that's cool. You're really humbling yourself. And, like, you're going back to the beginning. I'm like, I need to. You know, I was always able to fake my way around because I have a really good ear.
Right.
But I want to know.
Oh, we got froze up.
My phone tried to kill us for a second.
No, you're good. You're good. You're back. Oh, and we have, it looks like we're going to have one of your musician friends joining us here intermittently, also working on his internet connection. But dude, tell me what kind of bass you play.
I think that was them. They just called. I let my wife know. I think they just called for the.
Oh, wait, let me see.
I have a Warwick thumb bass.
A what bass?
A Warwick thumb bass.
Oh, nice.
I was actually, I was doing a play at the Public, and Michelle and DeGicello was performing, like, in a little pub next door.
Okay.
So I went to watch her, and I was like, you know, I love Michelle and DeGicello, and that bass was amazing, and she could make it sound like, you know, I could make it sound. But I was like, what is that bass? And I went out, and I bought one. And I had it in a gig bag, knew nothing about it. It just kind of messed around with it in band class. Another bass player's had it. And I went to the Blue Note and saw Ron Carter Trio.
Oh, shit.
And he was walking out, and he saw the gig bag, and he was like, yeah. And he's like, what is that? I said, it's a bass. He's like, what do you know about that? I was like, I don't know anything about it. And I just bought it. I said, you need to come to my house, and I'll give you a lesson.
Oh, wow.
My first bass lesson was with Ron Carter.
What, dude? That's crazy. When was this? This is a long time ago.
This is in the 80s. Yeah, this is 1980 something.
Oh,
or, yeah, 88, 89.
Damn, that is some shit. Dude, that's amazing. I just got this bass we use on the Leon album called a Sadowski. Are you familiar with that company? New York company? Like,
no.
Dude, I've been just a P bass guy my whole life. And I called Mike Elizondo, who is like the sort of like Dre bass player. And I was like, right, what's the bass I need for R&B music? And he was like, there's one bass you need. And I bought it and it changed our whole project. Unreal. Hey, wait a minute. Somebody's coming in. Somebody's coming in hot. Hold on. Hold on. Terrace Martin's in the building. What's up, dude?
What's up, man?
How you doing?
Who was this beginning? I think I met this actor at a workshop, a beginning workshop. Is that? Anyway. Oh, that's Don. Hey, what's up, Don?
Haven't you been into my house? Didn't you perform at a party at my house or something?
Yeah, with the palm trees in Portland.
Weren't you the best man at my wedding or something?
What's going on, fellas?
Man, nothing much. How you doing, Terrace?
I'm so sorry I'm late. I'm actually right by your studio, Ricky, but the internet was messed up where I'm at. I'm in Silver Lake right now.
Oh, damn. Mile stomping grounds.
Yeah. What's going on, fellas?
You going on.
Good talking about bases.
Great to see y'all. Great to see y'all, man.
Yeah, man. Terrace, how you doing, man?
Yes.
What kind of week is it? You and I talk a lot. We check in a lot. How you doing this week?
I'm cool, man. You know, I'm homeschooling. I realize I don't know much about school. I didn't learn that much because I'm homeschooling, and it's hard to teach kids because you realize how much I didn't pay attention in school for myself.
Yep.
But it's humbling. It's beautiful. You know, I'm really I feel like, you know what? I just turned 40, man, but I really feel like I'm just now.
Oh, damn.
Getting to learn me. I'm just now getting to figure me out, man, with this whole thing that's been going on with the pandemic, and just everything has been forcing me to look in the mirror and get some things together and get some things right, you know, not just with art and music, everything is art, but I you know, art is what I do, not what I am. So, you know, I'm really just getting that together, man. But otherwise, it's been positive, man. I've watched so much TV, man. So much fucking TV.
I know, right?
By the way, Don, hey.
Binging so
much. Bro, Don, your new shit so hard.
Yeah.
That shit so hard, bro.
Appreciate you.
I'm like, he.
Appreciate you.
Everything he do, he just crack it wide open. But you know my favorite Don Cheadle role, right? Because I'm from South Central LA. You know my favorite role?
What?
Rocket.
It's got to be Rocket.
Rocket, that's the shit.
I also got to give a shout out to one role just because I said I would. My mom loved you in Picket Fences, bro.
Yes.
Oh, tell your mom thank you very much.
I will. Oh, I will. I'm sure she's in the chat.
What's up, mom?
Supporting. Thank you, mom. Don, tell us how have you been personally through this time, mental health wise, like. You riding the waves like the rest of us? How you been doing?
You know, I'm very lucky. I live with a great woman who doesn't hate me yet and hasn't told me I need to go do something else. So we've been cohabitating and been, you know, been good. Actually, we've been kind of chill together. And I think, like Terrace is saying, it's given us a moment to really kind of take a beat and reassess lot of things and really, you know, figure out what's important, what's not important, you know, what matters, what we don't need to be stressing about, and how we want to come out of this, you know, and what we want to do on the other side of this whole thing, which I think is going to be years.
Yeah,
it's going to be years.
We're, agree.
I mean, maybe not in the same way. People are going to go back to work and people are going to get back to their own thing. But it's this COVID's here. We're going to be dealing with this for a minute.
Yeah.
So it's been a lot about perspective and, you know, trying to figure out where you want to put your energy and with family too, you know, it's like my kids are now kids. My kids are 25 and 23, you know, they're out there in the world trying to figure it out at a time when, you know, how do you start your life right now as an adult in the world, trying to get a job, trying to set up, you know, a place to live, occupation, all of that. It's like, it's a lot. And they're deep into the social justice right now. You know, I call my kids, I'm like, what are you doing? They're like, well, I was at this protest, I was at that protest. We're putting this dance thing together. We'll talk to both of y'all about, my kids are putting something together that I want to hit y'all to.
Beautiful.
We'll talk about it. But yeah, so that's what their life is about right now. And so as a parent, as we all know, that a lot of that is your life. So it's like, that's always playing in the background. Like, how can I leave this better for them? How can I support them? How can I let them do what they need to do and grow, but at the same time, try to, you know, put some buffers around some stuff, all of that.
Yeah. Damn. I mean, you're doing the right thing. And I think the thing that somebody, I forget who was on the show, mentioned earlier is like, all of us right now are kind of having a moment with identity when we have all these routines that make up who we think we are.
Yeah.
You know, 90% of those routines go away. And the person you are is a guy making a sandwich at 11 a.m. in your kitchen, you know, walking your dog.
Every day, just doing
4 months. Yeah. You're like, okay, it's a long look in the mirror. And some days that's good and some days that's hard. But I got to say, I'm really, really blessed to have met Terrace. And then through Terrace, also met you, Don. This album that Terrace helped create is incredible. And without this album, we wouldn't be raising money for these amazing organizations.
Come on now. Come on now.
Well, congrats to you guys on that. And I love both. I love what you guys are doing. And like we talked about the last time we were together, we're going to find ways to do some more stuff and build and just keep going. So, you know, boom, like that.
Beautiful. Well, guys, I'm going to move on to our next segment here. Thank you guys both so much.
Wait, no, you can't.
What?
You can't move on to your next segment.
Are you going to hang out backstage? Talk shit?
Yeah, with all this vodka.
Terrence just got a bottle of vodka in Silver Lake with a good Wi-Fi connection.
Wait, hey, let me say this, though.
He has a bottle of vodka. Vodka, no D in that word.
No, let me touch on this. What? So I just left Herbie's house, man. It's funny how you was talking to Don just now about real quick about just what's going on and everything and how we dealing with it. I asked Herbie today, I said, man, how you dealing with everything? I asked him, I said, man, are you ready for everything to get back normal, get back to this thing? And he was like, I'm not thinking about that. I'm thinking about today. I'm not thinking of, if I go on with my life saying one day it'll be like this, man, as he said, for this is not a quick fix. We have to live in this and get through this. And that's what I feel we're all doing, you know, is living through it and getting through it. Cause Herbie said, you can't think about when it's all good. You gotta make now good.
Right. Oh,
absolutely. Yeah. And we can't. And back to normal is nothing that we need to be talking about. We need to be going forward. We can't come on. Back seeing what normal has gotten us. We need to go forward. We need to be progressive.
Yeah, progressive.
Straight up. Back to normal is might as well be Make America Great Again. We're not going back.
Yeah, we need to go to 9th and 11th and Sharp and 13th. We need to be 9th, 11th.
No more tritones. We all need to work together.
No more tritones. We're stepping it up, guys.
Don is fresh off the music theory lesson.
Yeah, come on now. That's Miles, baby. Sure. He the only one that had the courage to do something like that, and I love him for that. Only one.
Oh shit, man. Yo, guys, this has been the shit. Thank you both so much, Don, Terrace. I'll probably talk to both of you guys in like an hour and a half about whatever project we're about to work on. So
let's do it.
Let's get it going.
I love y'all,
guys.
Y'all stay cool.
Thanks again. Talk to you both soon. Cheers. Peace.
Whoa, dude.
Fucking. Yo. That was fucking deep. People in the chat, you know where this show started. You know where it began. It began in my damn kitchen with me clinking spoons and making beats and having bad Wi-Fi. Now we got Don Cheadle. Ladies and gentlemen, we're going to keep it moving. I'm so stoked. This next performance is another debut. This is one of my favorite songs on the album. So moving, so beautiful. But we had some good friends of mine do a little edit to it. A live performance from Lito Pimienta and Sophie Tucker.
And the leaves will fall as I come to the end of the world for you, and all the lies beneath what I What I came for, I'll catch you.
How you doing?
I've been drawing the entire time since this started.
Wow.
Just drawing.
For some reason, I assumed you were going to say drinking. Oh, wow. I can actually see that really well, and it's incredible. What is
it? That's what I did when Don Cheadle was talking.
Really? That was the Don Cheadle inspiration art?
Yeah, I actually made two works of art.
Hmm.
So they're productive.
I didn't know. So when we first started talking, and we have to go through our whole story here, but when we first started talking about you being on the album, we started talking about music videos. You're like, I'm a visual artist. And I was like, yeah, I mean, we're all visual artists, aren't we? And you were like, no, I have like a second Instagram page. I'm like, okay, we all have a second Instagram. And then I saw it and I was like, oh, you like make like pottery and stuff.
Deal. I'm a big deal, Ricky Reed. Don't you know who I am? I'm a big deal.
I do now, Lito. So where are you coming to us from tonight? Where are you?
I am in my living room.
Okay.
Because I am renovating my whole music studio. It's in shambles. Mm. Boxes, wood everywhere. I'm installing kilns in the art studio that's all attached. And I think that in the hustle and the shuffle, the internet disappeared.
Yeah.
I am now home. I am in Toronto, Ontario. It is, what time is it? Oh my gosh. It is 1 a.m. for me.
Thank you. You know what? I appreciate you.
Yeah, I am really excited about the new pairs of shoes that you're going to send me. Pairs, plural.
I didn't realize that's what we were doing, but consider them. Someone in the chat, drop off some shoes. If you want, can you just say your address here on the air, and then we can.
Group Help sure. Management. Send it to all of them.
So
you can be one there.
I would talk to you about the music video, but we'll talk about that when people see that. Tell me about making the live video. Just that set you made. I felt like this is the damn MTV VMAs or something. It's crazy.
You know, your girl is a production. I'm a production.
Are a production. With
it. Sophie Tucker, I know they're extra with it too.
They are.
So I was like, the extra and the extra are meeting again. So let's do this. And that's part of the set from the video that we made for the song. So when we finished the video, the crew were like, well, I guess we're going to have to burn all these panels. And I was like, no, I'm going to bring them home.
Also, so, burn the very first idea? We're just going to set these up. Is that a Toronto thing?
It's a big set. And we worked on the video under such strange circumstances. We needed, what we did,
right.
Usually we do with a crew of at least 30 people. We did it with a crew of 7 people. So, it was also a way of being like, we did it. We accomplished this beautiful video.
Right,
let's have this ceremony and burn it all. And I'm like, no. We're going to keep that. And I'm going to put it in my studio. I'm remodeling it. I'm adding shelves. I'll work it out where I'll put them. And when you told me that Sophie Tucker did the remix, and I was like, wait a minute. And then you were like, if you could have some neon, it would be so nice. And I'm like, I got the neon. I got the pink. I got the yellow. I got the blue. I got all the colors. Don't worry about it. So that's what happened.
I love that. Oh my God, people, first of all, my group text is blowing up about your headpiece. So just people in the chat, if you're feeling Lito's drip, let us know. If you have any questions for her, let us know. Also, damn, Lito, we have got some major donations I need to shout out. So you've heard that we're working with a couple of mutual aid climate action groups. We got an anonymous donation for $250, an anonymous $2,500 donation. Oh, $20, $50. They're rolling in now. This is amazing.
Yes.
If you're feeling Lito, another $300 anonymous donation. I got a Lito will sing. What will you sing a chorus of? What top 40 pop song will you sing if somebody does a donation, a big one? What's your guilty pleasure pop song?
Believe in life after love. Feel some things I said. I really don't think it's strong enough.
Ooh. Hey, there we go. What did that get us, internet? Did that get us anything? I think so. I think it should.
I can think of some like Spanish pop songs too.
Yes.
some telenovela songs.
We don't talk about this often, but how is this whole thing for you right now? The COVID moment. Like, how are you holding up? How are you on this roller coaster, man?
Well, first of all, I'm a baby mama. Okay? I got kids.
Yeah.
I don't got time to ponder about my existence as an artist in the construct of the landscape, of the political landscape that I gotta wash the butt. I gotta clean the house and I gotta do the dishes. So for me,
right,
it's you know, I got the news that the tour was canceled. You know, I just released an album called Miss Colombia. Go mm-hmm. check it out.
We love okay. it.
Okay. Amazing. It. And then, of course, I'm not on tour. Mm-hmm. So I was like, well, so the first thing that I did, and this is around the time that you messaged me with a box folder of like a million, 50,000, trillion, quadrillion loops and samples. And, I was unboxing. I was taking my studio, art studio and music studio out of the boxes that I had in storage because mm-hmm. I was supposed to go on tour for 2 years or something. So I don't know. I mean, I'm Colombian, from Colombia, South America. So when you're from Colombia, you are already in like pandemic mode. Like you don't know what's gonna happen next. So you just prepare and you're just ready for the next tragedy. You're just ready for the next. You know, and I feel like,
yeah.
like, you know, people in the States right now are really feeling that since, you know, the last presidencies, you know, with like immigration and now with this presidency, people are really feeling like anything bad can happen at any moment now.
Right.
So for me, in terms of, you know, what to do now, I am an artist. I can't go on tour anymore. Oh, I cannot create. What can I do now? And you know, yeah. I don't have a life. It's okay. I'll just make some pictures and I'll, you know, do the same thing that you're doing right now. I'll raise money for people. I actually have a fundraiser going on GoFundMe to raise funds for elders, musicians of traditional music in Colombia who don't have a pension because oh, wow. their work is not recognized as work because they don't belong to any company. They're traditional musicians.
Right.
And our country is very, like the government right now, they're very pro-Trump, which means that all funding is out of culture, even though what do you know Colombians for?
I mean, you guys are the best.
Yeah. That's how we know each other, through music, through our
Bomba Stereo, man. We got to shout them out too, our people.
Exactly. So That's the reality for a lot of us. So my brain just instantly went to, I'm going to work. When it first started, though, I thought, you know, this is going to be a week. It's going to be a month, you know. So I ordered blank records of my album. And then I started still screening. And I did a limited edition run of vinyl.
Oh, wow.
And that's how my first month went. Like, I was just like, painting. I was isolating because I had just come from Europe. So I was like, this is going to be a month, you know, and didn't open my email. I was just really like in my feelings.
Right.
But then I was like, girl, snap out of it. You got kids.
Right. And then somebody sent you a box folder with 30,000 samples.
Yes. What? And actually, I mean, I already kind of said it on Twitter, but I should say it again. When Ricky messaged me, I honestly thought that you made a mistake. Like, I honestly thought that you wanted like something from Liliana, or that, you know, we missed like some vocals, or that you missed a sample from the songs with Bomba. And I was like, he's got the wrong email. No, you got the wrong person, Mr. Ricky Reed, big producer guy. And then, you know, and then I was like, oh no, he's just like a silly happy, nice, white dude. It's okay. I'm fine.
Silly, happy, nice, white dude.
Oh, listen.
I'll take that. I'll take those things. Mm-hmm. Man, well, the work on the song is crazy. I haven't even officially said this yet, but the album has now been out for an hour. I think we got
some playlists. Your song got a couple playlists. I'm seeing that in my group chat.
So that's what we like. I mean, we need all the help we can.
Can I also say something?
What, please?
This is my official first real song in English.
Right.
And this was something that it was like a little, like an added to the anxiety of doing a song with Ricky Reed, because I thought, honestly, I thought that I was writing this song for Billie Eilish or Alessia Cara or Jessie Reyes. Like, I thought that I was, you know, I'm going to write a song for like a, you know, a beautiful sing, you know, because my songs are like the opposite of what I'm singing here. I don't sing about, I'll catch you, I got you. I don't think about that. I'm thinking about, I gave birth.
I'll drop you.
And the blood came out of me. And I, as a woman, I'm in the darkness and the void of my emotions. Very different.
Very different.
In Spanish, it's like, you know, it sounds very poetic and whatever, but in English, so I'm still very anxious about it. When I hear the song, I'm still like, oh my God, people can tell that I don't speak the English. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's hard. Dude,
I think you did just an amazing job, and I'm so very proud of how it came out, proud of our collaboration. I want, though, to show you one other song before I let you go. See if you're familiar with this. Do you know this song?
One for the road. Need a whoa.
He's for the Lido. He's for the show. Thank you for coming on tonight. A pleasure as always. I'll probably talk to you tomorrow.
You probably text me about something.
I will. Yeah. I will. I'll talk.
Watch out for the video. They got you. It's
happening. I love you. I'll see you soon.
Bye, Ricky. Bye-bye. Bye. Keep going.
Woo! Ladies and gentlemen, how amazing is Lido? Wow. What a treat. What a guest. What? Just goofing. It's all goofing tonight. On a more serious note, I want to get to our next performance. What you're going to see is an artist named Baloba, also known as DJ Stanfill, close friend of mine, frequent collaborator on the album. He made the song We'll Be Home Soon. It's an interlude towards the end of the album. And he also played the keyboards and co-produced the Godfather song, which is on the album. So we're going to do a little bit of a medley right now. Buckle up. Those of you who have been with me for a long time have definitely seen and heard some of this before. But here it is, world exclusive performance, Baloba and Godfather, right here on Nice Live 40.
With my bare hands and feet, I'll start over again. Oh, get it right, where everyone else got it. That we'll be home soon.
scared of the future. I'm afraid of failure. After all these years, I'm still in this body. I can't believe it. What's the meaning? Why stop dreaming? High speed streaming. Mind is deceiving. Inside I'm screaming. Fighting this feeling. Yeah, I'm fighting the healing. Who could ever love me? Love me. I'm only nice when I want something. Voices in my head tell me I'm nothing. Could anybody love me? Love me. Love me. I was too focused on the wealth. I could use something else. Are you lonely like me? Are you lonely like me? Sick of looking at myself. I could use someone else. Are you lonely like me? Are you lonely like me? I need interaction, I need satisfaction. I've been locked down, virus got me snapping. All of a sudden something happened. Went from big bragging to missing all the action. Staring at the screen got me hopeless. I think I might break any moment. If I had you, could I hold it down and make the whole thing worth it? I was too focused on the wealth. I could use something else. Are you lonely like me? Are you lonely like me? Sick of looking at myself. I could use someone else. Are you lonely like me? Are you lonely like me?
Back, amazing performance from Biloba, Godfather. Thank you guys both so much for coming through, being a part of the record. If either of you are in the chat, say what's up, please. Oh, Anonymous just donated $250. That is awesome. We're going to bring out our next guest, who's very close with one of the organizations that has been one of the groups that we're donating towards tonight. And if anybody in the chat can let me know what our... Whoa! We just got a $1,000 donation! Crazy! If anybody can let me know what number we're up to right now, I would love to know. But I'm going to bring out our next guest. Singer, producer, visionary. One of the voices on the song Us, How Sweet It Was. Ladies and gentlemen, coming at us from New York... It's Duendita. Hi.
Hey.
How you doing?
How are you? Good. How are you?
I'm good. 108 East Coast time. How you feeling?
Yeah. I'm like, woo.
Yep. Thank you for I'm gonna dim my light a little bit just to get a little bit more of a moody, you know, just a moody energy. How are you?
I'm chilling.
Yeah?
I'm chilling. Yeah. It rained a little today, you know?
It rained? Oh, so jealous.
Oh, you're jealous?
Yeah, dude. Oh, my God. Real quick, before we do anything else, we're about to hit $20,000 right now.
Nice. Rack it up. Thank you so much for donating.
People. Amazing. This is crazy. So I wanted to check in with you because... You know, we talked about the song, which is amazing. It's out. The album's out. We're very happy. But you put us onto the Good Life Garden, and all of our people are very excited about it, excited to learn about it. Have you been by recently?
Yeah. I was there last night.
At night? Wait, what do you do at a garden at nighttime?
Kofi was burning some, like, wood chips and stuff. And I was staring at the flames. I'm not even joking. I'm kind of like afraid of fire, so like anytime I see something, you know, I'm a city girl, so anytime I see fire or something, I'm like, whoa, dude, elements.
Yep. The element. Yeah. No, it's weird. Fire, we were just talking about this earlier. Fire, and specifically out here in California, wildfires are a trigger for me. But when I'm around a contained fire, dude, I will just kick it.
Nice.
I will just kick it and stare. And are you a Game of Thrones person? Is that your bag?
No.
They had some shit in that show where like you could like hear stuff or see stuff if you like stared into a fire long enough.
Oh wow.
Like ideas and people and things and.
Yeah.
Maybe it's just me. Let's talk about Jack Harlow.
Oh my god.
Let's talk about Jack Harlow.
He's my obsession.
Well, I wanted
that little bitch who got there.
He is. He made it. He made it, man. I mean, the people in the chat are probably like, why did you just say that? But I gotta say, when we were sound checking earlier, you said the most surprising thing to me that I could have ever heard, which was that you're obsessed with the man. I love his shit. I love his records. Obviously, What's Poppin' is incredible. How did you discover him? Like, what was the beginning of your journey with Jack?
I don't know what it was. It might have been What's Poppin' and the video. I'm a fairly new Jack Harlow fan. It's been like a few weeks.
Okay.
But I've consumed all of the Harlow content there is on the internet.
You've
there's no more interviews for me.
Did
to
you
watch,
scroll so, like, all the way down on the Instagram? You check out.
Yes, I did.
You liking it, something that's like 217 weeks old? Duendita liked this high school basketball.
No, the worst is when you read
practice.
People's likes on Twitter. I read well, what he liked on Twitter.
Oh man. So. Is it like the whole project, like the mixtape? What are you listening to? Is it just What's Poppin' on repeat?
Once What's Poppin' through the night. He has like some dope like singles, some cool projects. Like they're dope, but I really like his like more pop records.
Right. He's the shit, man. Whoa.
Yeah.
Okay. Real quick, we hit 20K. I had to nice. Interrupt this for a minute. That's amazing. Dude, that's like a Toyota Civic? What? A new one? Is that a RAV?
I could definitely buy something on Midnight Club with that money.
Bro. So I want to go back just for a second to the garden. What, like, I actually did an interview today. This is the best thing ever. I did an interview, and they were like, can we talk about some non-music stuff? And I was like, fucking can we please? Yes. And we talked about how I love grocery shopping, and I make my popcorn every day. But we talked about my garden. And I wanted to ask you, what are your sort of, like, gardening go-to things?
Gardening go-to things?
Yeah, like, what do you like to plant? Or what would you plant? What would you plant if you could plant anything? Is also a good question. There we go.
Wow, that's a really good question. You know what's crazy? Mm. I was like in Santa Rosa, kind of like where the fires are right now.
I know Santa Rosa very well.
Yeah, I was in Healdsburg.
Yep.
I don't know if you know Healdsburg. But my friend had a plum tree, right?
A plum tree? Like,
yeah, I was like, this is next level. Like, you can just pick it off the tree. We were supposed to be picking them off for like a plum pie, but okay. I was just eating.
Dude,
I was just picking them up and eating and throwing the pit in the wild. And I guess if I could have anything, I would want a tree where I can just grab the food off, like a plum tree.
That's
if I could grow anything. But in New York, I don't think that that's going to happen.
Yeah, it's tough. I mean, that's my shit with my daughter is like, she, anything she can just pick and eat, we grow. So we do like, we got cherry tomatoes, strawberries, of course, cucumbers. Nice. We got bell peppers popping up now. Very nice. But yo, something I'm particularly proud of. I bought some sweet potatoes, organic. I did the thing where you put them like in a jar of water and then like the little buddies.
Oh, nice.
Go off of them. And then I planted the little buddies and the little buddies are going crazy now.
Wow. Propagation, I think it is.
Propagation.
It might be called something different when you use a veggie.
Yeah. I don't know. But I am in love with my sweet potato section.
Nice.
I wish I could just go, like, just take this whole rig and just fucking bring you guys up to just show it off. Because it's my shit.
You got a few plants back there, I see.
I do. I kind of decked out the zone. I, like, put, like, a mood light thing. Yeah. You seeing it?
Yeah.
Yeah. It's got some energy. I'm so stoked that you are on the album in the first place, just first of all, and that you introduced us to Kofi. This whole process, like everything about it, from meeting you a couple years ago, leading up to where we are now, it's always a great energy with you. I'll say that.
Hey, thank you. We got more to go.
We do. Honestly, if you need some shit, or you got some shit that needs some production help.
Dude, that kick just sounds just like, God night, I think.
Yeah. That's the vibe, dude. Awesome. Well, I'm going to let you go. I don't want to keep you too long because it is late where you are. I would be dying. Before I let you go, though, I want to give a quick shout out to Greater Goods Company. They've been dropping $200 donations in here like it ain't no thing. Another anonymous 1,000. Bro, this is amazing. This is amazing. Candace, thank you so much for coming through. It's, you are amazing. I'll probably talk to you tomorrow. Text me.
Yeah.
See you soon.
Have a good one. Enjoy this.
Bye.
Bye.
Ooh, yeah. Man, we're rocking. Okay, so seen a lot of people talk about the song Favorite Boy in the chat tonight. An amazing song that came together right here live before your very eyes. That song was started with a loop from an amazing producer named Knobs. John Robert wrote a vocal to it. I had another amazing musician named Zach Seekoff do some production work on it. I eventually finished producing it, and as is released tonight, Alessia Cara jumped on. It's an amazing song. But what's really cool is Alessia couldn't record a performance for this show, but I thought what would be really cool would be to reach out to one of the songwriters on the record. So coming at you guys for the first time, brand new exclusive performance, we got John Robert, Knobs, Zach Seekoff, and Jensen McRae performing Favorite Boy. Let's go. Thank you.
hardly knew him. That's an overstatement. Didn't know him at all. And I got no tears. Truth told, I'm hardly sorry. Should I miss a stranger? And does it matter at all? Drove to Richmond to see your sister's wedding. Spoke about the sermon being misogynistic. And you had no tears. Truth told, you're hardly happy. It's tough to care for strangers, even if they're your family. I wanna be your favorite boy. I wanna be your favorite toy. I wanna be your favorite boy. Oh, I wanna be your toy.
Make me laugh till my belly hurts. Who the hell was I before you? In so many words. Been better since I've known you. When I get a little short-fused, you know just how to call me. More so than anybody. So grateful that you love me. I wanna be your baby girl. I wanna be your universe. I wanna be your baby girl. You go changing for me. It's all just the wave we're beneath. Don't you go changing on me. You're the only thing I see. I see.
Wow. If there's ever been a time to shout out the man editing these videos, the legend, my engineer, all gas, no brakes, Ethan Schumacher, the food intruder. Ethan, cheers, buddy. That shit was crazy. And also, thank you for incredible performances from all those artists. I mean, how insane are these videos? I swear to God, the text that I send to them is, can you send an acapella, a video of yourself performing acapella? And we get the stuff that we're getting. You know, for the instrumentalists, Knobs, can you film a video of you just doing what you do on guitar? Zach Seekoff, you want to accompany this? Yeah, I'll play bass. Cool. And it turns into that. And the amazing surprise edition of Jensen McRae just crushing the verse. Jensen, amazing job. Vocal tone. Vocal tone 101. Man, well, it would be really nice if we could, if I could find some way to just like let you guys see the whole gang here. Hold on, let me. Okay, I'm gonna see if I can get the whole group chat, because we have an amazing team: the Nice Life record label, publishing company, the stream team. None of us know how to do any of this. We were talking about this the other day. We were like, how does ESPN do this? Like, we don't know how to produce television. We don't know how, I didn't know how to stream anything. Like, this whole thing, we've just sort of stuck together and figured it out while the amazing people in this chat have been with us since March. It's been amazing. So I'm going to see if I can bring up the whole gang. for you guys to meet right now. If this works, I am going to be shocked.
Oh, shit. Here he is. Oh, boy.
Oh, boy.
Wait a minute. Wait a minute, you jokers.
Hello.
What?
Hey, it's the Knife.
Hey, baby.
Hey.
What up?
Hey, baby.
Here they are.
Yeah.
Wow.
Classe gang. Wrench gang becomes Classe gang.
Oh, man. We're like the Brady Bunch here.
It's pretty cute. Yeah.
It's a very there's Vlad is in the
why is he killing himself?
Vlad is not a
Vlad with the background.
This is so good.
Wow, Trump's it all.
This
wow.
is all we drink. All we drink.
Boom.
Come on now.
Oh boy. Everybody in the chat, welcome. Welcome to my world here for a minute. I want to do a quick round of introductions. This is the amazing, amazing team that is behind everything that we do here. I want everyone just to sort of introduce themselves, and then we're going to drink some of this booze. First of all, to my whatever direction this is the
That's
food
not gonna
intruder.
Work.
We can't see that, bro.
Oh, we don't know, guys. This shit's wild.
Okay. The video editor, all gas, no brakes. Ethan, introduce yourself, please.
Heyo. My name is Ethan Shoemaker, and I like to drink, and I like to watch this show and make it for you all, and I like to be a part of your lives, and thank you for bringing me into your world.
Okay. Very cute.
Yes, Ethan.
Very cute. Okay, to his the side of him, to the side of him is Brad. Hi, Brad.
Oh, shit. Hello. Brad, GM of Nice Life. It was a wonderful 40 episodes with you all, and the album's out.
Yeah.
Stream, share, say.
Yeah.
Like and subscribe, whatever. let's go directly below me is actually is Ian, who's been a real pivotal member of the stream team. Ian.
Woo! We stand.
Hey. We stand.
It's me, woo! Ian Galdi, pivotal member of the stream team. Equal parts. Excited, exhausted, and drunk. The room's out. We will be streaming. Thank the Swifties.
We're the Swifties.
Love y'all.
Thank the Swifties. Where the Swifties at?
Yeah, thank the Swifties.
Where the Swifties at? We love y'all.
We love
We're coming for you, Katie. We're coming for you, Katy Perry.
Yes.
Damn.
MB, what's up?
Hey, I'm Martha Blair. I work on the management side with Larry. It's been really fun watching the stream, and I've loved to see how everything's come together.
Man, and you've been excellent throughout this process. Over to the other side is Sam. What's up, dude?
What's up? I'm Sam Berger. I'm responsible for making sure CDs of The Room will be available at your local Tower Records.
Yeah, Sam.
Hey. Yes, we love it. We love it. Let's go directly down from Sam, someone you guys might be familiar with, GZV.
Hello, guys. Y'all know me from the show. Happy to be here. You know, send me demos for next season. We want to hear. And yeah, stream The Room.
We love it. And now I really want to give a big, big, this is somebody, I had this whole idea basically to do this, to introduce you, Caitlin, was really my whole plan, because Caitlin is one of the people who has not been on the show very much, but she has had to bust her ass, particularly at the beginning of this, while we were amassing demos and doing the thoughtful roast. Caitlin was really, really, really grinding out for us. So I want the crew to give a round of applause real quick for Caitlin.
You're there to me.
All y'all gotta know is Caitlin is the final boss, and
yes,
that's the tea.
Caitlin,
the secret behind the Jazz V email. Yeah,
exactly.
There you go. Whoa.
Exactly.
Ooh.
Caitlin, tell us
the big reveal, the season finale reveal.
The season finale.
Oh boy, you having a good night, Caitlin?
Yeah, I mean, we started from your kitchen, and I think in the duration of that episode, I cried twice. And now I'm drinking on the couch, and you know, Dave Longstreet is on my computer. It's crazy.
There we go. Let's see if we can get to cry number three tonight.
Yeah, really. Happy tears this time, not anxiety tears.
Yes. Oh, we've all had those.
But yeah, I'm just super like grateful for the community that I feel like we've built. Not only like, you know, it's been great to have the crew during the pandemic, and the people we've like met in the chat have all been super awesome. And yeah, stream the room. It's here, guys. We did it.
Yay.
Yay.
To your side is Tony Messina and A&R. Tony, could you introduce yourself?
Hey, what's up? I'm Tony. Just want to say congrats to everyone. And it's like all the performances have been amazing. I'm just completely blown away by what y'all have been able to put together. And yeah, I can't wait to listen to the album. It's amazing.
Oh man. Thank you, Tony. Well, let's go to Larry, Mr. Larry Wade next, the Classe Azul, the reason for the season. There it is.
So I'm the brand ambassador for a Classe Azul. Probably the reason why you can't get it in stores anymore. And it went from being $100 to now $200 to Brad Chagrin. And I'm happy to be here. Well, no, yours, because you bought it and then she can look at you. Anyway, we'll go side conversation. Sure. Anyway, congrats, Ricky. Put together a great body of work, and long time coming. I'm sure you have had many stressed out nights of trying to finish the album along with the other team, other parts of the team helping you out. But great night. Congrats to you all. And this is awesome. Happy to be here.
Hell yeah, dude. Thank you so much. And let's close with Vlad, because Vlad called me in the middle of the stream and it almost exploded. Did you guys hear the ring watching the show? Like, did you hear the ding 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 ding? Because it was crazy. Vlad's not a member of our record label. We wish he was, but we do have him do many things for us. Vlad, you want to introduce yourself?
My name is Vlad. I'm the actual Casa Azul brand sponsorship right here.
Did you say
Assay Azul? Assay
Azul.
Yes.
Assay Azul brand ambassador.
Let's do a quick cheers to.
Oh yeah, here let me. I got
a quick toast. I'm gonna give it to the wings of friendship, or the feathers of what is it?
So the feathers of the wings of friendship never fall off, and may the hinges of love never rust. Cheers!
Wow!
Cheers!
Cheers,
guys! This is later than I drink tequila. Now
it's Thursday night.
Ooh, it's good.
Thursdays is College Friday. Let's go.
That's right. Go. Guys, thank you guys all so
much. Thursday, Ricky Reed. Thursday, man.
Stream the album. Thank you, guys.
I'm donating right now. Everyone else, go donate right now.
Go donate right now.
We did pass the 20K mark.
Hey.
All right, baby, come on, Anonymous, come through, Anonymous.
I love you guys so much. I'm gonna jump. Stay in the chat because we have a few more surprises. Team, thank you guys so much for coming through. I love you guys.
Thank you. Congrats,
Ricky.
Cheers.
Congrats.
Bye.
Bye, y'all.
Wow, that worked. I think that worked. Did that work? I think it worked. That was tight. Technological, pretty advanced over here these days. We've come We've come a long way. We are getting near the end of our show. Getting close to the end. One more performance, one more guest. I have to do a quick on-air shout out to all the amazing people in this chat that have made made this sort of a second home for me, a place that I know that I can come to when I need somebody to lift me up, to feel good, to pour my heart out, to do whatever it is. And I want to give a shout out to all you guys. You guys have been amazing. The Nice Life chat. You guys made me a song on my birthday. You guys have just been the community that I'm so, so proud to be a part of. I want to remember, say all the names I can remember on here. Jack Hardwick, Czar, Alexander Frieden, Aaron DeMoyton, Vazen. Where's the crew? Claire, what's up, Sophie, Leanna, Cowboy Lansky. What an amazing, amazing crew you guys are. I love you guys so much, and I'm so, so proud. Oh, Jeremy Jackson, Evan Mahalski, Evan H, if he's here also. Default Tone, where's Default Tone at? It's been just an amazing, amazing, amazing journey with you guys, and I could not be happier. So without further ado, we're going to get to our next performance. Part of this was recorded, I think, 3 or 4 days ago. And part of it is going to be recorded right now. Ladies and gentlemen, this should be real magic.
Just take your time, count your blessings. Just stay right here for a second, yeah. It's a free world, let me get lost up in it. Just take your time, count your blessings. Just stay right here for a second, yeah. It's a free world, let me get lost up in it. All of the love was making a world all this while, and all the light that you left behind is way up somewhere in the clouds, coming back around. Down.
happens every once in a while.
Ladies and gentlemen, I got one more guest and one more guest only. Let's just bring her out. No, needs no introduction. Ladies and gentlemen, the one and only
St.
Panther. What's up, dude?
How you doing, Ricky Reed?
I'm doing okay, man.
Yeah?
Nice to see you. Nice to see you as always. How are you?
Beautiful to see you as always. It's been so long since the last time I saw you. It was only yesterday.
It was quite literally yesterday. Yeah, it really was.
Yeah, man. I'm so excited. It's finally coming tonight, man. This music is just incredible, and I'm just so glad I got to be a small piece of this whole operation. That was just
small piece. Beautiful.
You know.
Did I hear small?
I helped a little bit.
Like, literally, you're literally like the impetus, like the spark, you know, like maybe I've been dumping gasoline on a, you know, pile of tinder for 7 years, but you were the spark,
dude.
And I'm just forever grateful for that.
I'm forever grateful to just be sharing music with you and everyone around us. And it's just been such an incredible journey of like realizing how connected we are, even though we're going through all this, we're all together, we're all here for each other, we're creating music together. It's just, you know, this is all we can ask for when we get together, you know.
All we can ask for. I mean, I knew we had to end the show with you just because, like, not only were you so instrumental in kicking the whole thing off, but like the people in the chat, like, you know, we've premiered your songs on here. We've had so many different moments. You've been putting out music, man. You've had a lot of stuff going on.
We've been putting out music, man. It's been such a great year. I've noticed just how much music we've all been making, and it's just incredible. Like, no matter what, you know, we're pushing in music, and it's just,
right,
growing to be this incredible thing, you know.
Right. You know, you are, I feel like the sort of textbook definition for me of somebody who gives me hope, because people who are optimistic without sort of really taking in what's actually going on, without being clear-eyed and being realistic about how gnarly things are. I feel like you're somebody who uniquely understands, you know, the dark stuff and the scary stuff and how heavy everything is right now. And through that, you have unshakable optimism and positivity and hope. And it comes out in the music, but it also comes out in hanging out with you. How do you do that? I want to know.
I appreciate that, man. I don't know. I think it's really just having so many moments that are like put you at eye level with life, that kind of have you searching for the most positive and vibrating, you know, above even the darkest moments. You know, it all just exactly like through this, I've kind of realized like there's light in every moment. you know, if you look for it and if you hold on to it too, it's such an important part of yourself. It's an important part of the world. We all have a little bit of light in us. I think it's really important to hold on, you know, and just remember it, you know, because it's always a part of you.
That's yes.
A real thing.
I don't think I've ever, I don't think I've ever said this. I don't think I've ever said this, but that's the line of real magic that got me. It was all the light that you left behind, way up somewhere in the clouds, etc. But it was that right. line, and I thought about my daughter. I thought about how much light she has and how much she's a light in my life and a light to the world. And in that moment, I was feeling like that, like all the light that you left behind, that it was like in past tense, like her light was in past tense, and
right.
and feeling like this moment was going to deny her from being the light that she is. But what I've learned is that my daughter's a lot like you, and she is resilient and she's strong and she's fearless, and a future where people are listening to what she has to say, much like a future where people are listening to what you have to say, is actually a future that we can all be pretty excited about.
Man, well, I appreciate that. No words can say how much I appreciate that. And just being able to, you know, share in these experiences together is just so meaningful. And honestly, just ties it all together for me. And being able to just have a piece of that light in the music and in the community we've created here is just, it's really a light in the tunnel, you know, because we're still in the tunnel, but there's light in here and we're creating it ourselves. And that's what I kind of learned through this whole experience is like, the light is anywhere you are, you know.
We're still in the tunnel, but there's light in here.
Yeah.
That's great. We don't have to get to the end yet. I mean, it's going to be nice, but like we have light in here now.
Yeah. We're shining through.
Bro. Ladies and gentlemen, nice live 40. All of our guests. Thank you everybody for coming through. The album, my new album, The Room, made by me and my beautiful community that I'm a part of. Thank you so much. St. Panther, we love you. Everyone in the chat, we love you, we love you, we love you. We'll be around. Don't be strangers. Come find us. And we raised over $20,000 tonight, Daniela. $20,000. My people. Thank you so much, guys. We love you. And we'll see you soon. We're just going to rock out for a minute.